Well, police say many of these thefts are the work of a loosely organized gang, and authorities believe they may have struck twice this weekend just over the border in Massachusetts.
Police say this window at the Lawrence District Court was smashed out by a vehicle driven by thieves looking to take the ATM inside. These police photographs show a cash machine that was ripped open and pieces of a vehicle's lamp cover on the ground. Authorities say this is one of a string of similar ATM thefts that may be the work of the same gang.
We believe there's approximately 12 individuals who are involved, and they've been targeting machines, ATM machines, as far south as Connecticut, as far north as Maine. I believe every one of the New England states have been targeted, I think, over the course of about 3 years.
Salem has been a target of the ring for the last couple of years. This video from April 2006 shows two masked men trying to remove the ATM at Look Oil convenience store. Days later, cameras captured another ATM theft from a Salem business. In each case, police thought the same group of thieves could be responsible.
We have been in contact with other agencies. We do believe it is probably some type of organized crime ring that is going around hitting these making these ATM thefts. We are working, our investigative services division is working with other agencies, and we have been in contact with many agencies around this area.
This weekend, they hit again in Methuen, Massachusetts. An ATM was taken from the lobby of this credit union.
They were able to get in by using a swipe card that was either theirs or someone else's. Once they got in, they were able to push the cameras up towards the ceiling to take the cameras off of them. But before they did that, we did get a view of the suspect and a possible vehicle involved.
The surveillance pictures show a masked person inside the lobby of the credit union and what appears to be a red SUV in the parking lot.
Police say they are working on several strong leads, but have not yet been able to identify any suspects. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.